Welcome to another episode, guys. My name is Samantha Mahmood, and I am back with a new review. So stick around, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this. This week, Diane won the veto power. And what's funny is that we see her old friend Sadie go to talk to her. Meanwhile, the entire week he'd been spending all of his time with Shayi and Tacha. Also, Ello and Diane got closer this week. I think it's very clear that they enjoy each other's company. But Diane has said, however, that she will not think too much about their relationship, at least not until he defines it. For the head of house tax, we had four top contenders, which were Cindy, Venita, Mercy, and Shayi. And in the end, Shayi won the head of house for the second time in a row. He chose Tacha to share his room with, but Tacha declined, so he chose Venita. The nomination process for this week was interesting, as housemates had to compete in their groups. You know, we have the groups Icon and the Christopian, and they were judged as groups and not individually. Mike helped out his team Christopia with that extra point that they needed, and that meant that the Icons were automatically put up for eviction. Sadie broke down. He cried because he felt he had disappointed himself and his team. But veto power holder Diane saved Sadie and replaced him with a team member of her own, Joe. Ella was also confused that Diane had not saved him. To make the whole situation more annoying, Sadie sought a pity party by crying, and Kathy was just comforting him. The housemates up for eviction were Fraud, Tacha, EK, Joe, Ello, NK, Omarshola, and Cindy. Venita, in her diary session, was very emotional, and she also revealed to Big Brother that she believes that no one in the house has her back. But then, in a conversation with Joe, she admits that she considers Gedoni as a best friend, but the issue is she doesn't have a lot of love for Gedoni's girl, Kathy. Kathy, on the other hand, is uncomfortable because of the inappropriate things Venita has said about her man. From openly admiring him to teasing her about sharing Gedoni with her, those sentences plus Gedoni's distance had her on the edge. Both Venita and Kathy also had very mean things to say about each other. Venita referred to Kathy as a demon, while Kathy claimed Venita was unhappy to see other people's relationship thrive because of her broken marriage. Kathy and Gedoni were not going to give up so easily on their relationship though, because this week we saw them take steps to rebuilding their bond and trust. But this move threw Venita off once again, and she was back to feeling lonely, which made her state that Fraud played her. She said he wanted to eat his cake and have it by spending equal time with both herself and Esther. But speaking of Fraud, can we talk about his dedication towards Esther? Even though it's so clear that this girl doesn't like him at all, it's so one-sided. But we can only hope that the ice will melt away soon and Fraud will get back some love in return. The housemates got a tax from Big Brother, courtesy of Heritage Bank, which was a coronation of the new head of house as the Tortive. They all put in their collective efforts in ensuring that the tax went smoothly. Although at the initial stage, there were disagreements when some housemates felt they should have been given bigger roles to play. When they eventually presented their tax, it was both colorful and creative, and Big Brother went all out for this one. Shayi was dressed as Tortive, Diane as Queen Amina, Sadie as the Emir of Kano, and so many other tribes. It was very beautiful, especially with the Calabari dancers. They had been invited to perform, and of course, the different delicacies provided. More so, kudos to Mike for taking his role as an old Yoruba chief very seriously. I believe it was a very good attempt. Gedoni also did quite well as an MC. And Shayi, of course, looked every part a king. It was so impressive to see the display of one of Nigeria's tribes and African culture to millions of viewers who were tuned in. Well done, Heritage Bank. After their tax presentation, Gedoni and Kathy officially resolved things. They got in bed together and talked things over, with Gedoni admitting to have fallen for Kathy and promising to take responsibility for whatever may happen. Joe received a strike for provoking Tacha, Tacha received one for slapping Joe, and Ike received one also for initiating a fight between himself and Shayi. The house in general received warnings for their reckless behavior. People have also come for Jackie for her closeness towards Mike this week. Rehearsals for their wager tax commence, and it was not long before Shay and Mike got into an argument. Shay believes the earth is flat, yo, and he was quick to tell everyone on his team that what they've ever believed in all their life is false. Mike thought it was baseless as it lacked facts, and Mike then said they should add this argument in their presentation. But Shay was not having it because he felt Mike was only trying to tease him, and then he proceeded to address Mike in his usual authoritative manner. Mike shut him down though. He said, "I'm a man. You can't raise your voice at me and expect me to just roll over." And it's true, Shay needs to learn to be respectful, especially with his approach towards adults. While the right team, who were the icons, rehearsed and worked on perfecting their acts. When it was time to present, we all knew the icons would shine because they had put in work. They had the right elements, dance, comedy and drama, and overall they had people who were willing to forgo their egos and just work. The Christopians fell a bit short, but Venita's monologue was equally touching and powerful, and Joe's artwork of the coat of arms was very impressive. The icons won, and the Christopians, hoping to encourage themselves, converged for a meeting. Everyone spoke about, you know, their flaws, and Mike and Shay even made up with a hug. Although the icons rubbed this in their faces, especially Thatcher, who walked in on their meeting. Epstar shouted, she was like, "You better leave our room." And in the end, there was no like exchange of blows. Cindy's character evolved and blossomed. She's a very hardworking individual and a very competitive one. I'm loving her character more every day, and I'm just looking forward to see the value that she adds into the show. For the Friday Arena Tax Game, the housemates were divided into three groups. The first group consisted of Shay, Omashola, Kathy, Gedoni, Diane, and Cindy. Second group were made up of Tacha, Joe, Elozonam, Sir D, NK, and Venita. And the last group were Mike, Ike, Mercy, Jackie, Esther, and Fraud. In the end, group 3 had the best score for the evening, and each member were rewarded with 100 Bet Angel coins each. Big Brother also acknowledged those housemates who had done tremendously well in the previous tag, people like Fraud, Elo, NK, Joe, and Venita, and for that reason, he decided to gift the housemates drinks. But then an argument ensued between Fraud and Shay over the drinks. Shay claimed that he had ordered drinks from Big Brother and Big Brother had delivered them, therefore he had to take his own drinks to the room. And Fraud was like, "No, let's share the drinks, because in my own tenor, when I was head of house, you said that we should not be taking drinks to the room." Ike was nowhere in sight. The housemates also celebrated Joe's birthday this week, and they had kind words to say about him. On Saturday, Big Brother presented them with another tag. This one was courtesy of Dano Milk. The housemates were each divided into groups of three. Team Dano Kukau was a group of Thatcher, Elo, and Ike. Team Dano Choco, we had Esther, Shay, and Venita. Team Dano Slim were made up of Jackie, Mike, and Gedoni. Team Dano Strawberry had Fraud, Omashola, and Kathy. Team Dano UHT, NK, Sadie, and Cindy. And Team Dano Full Cream, Mercy, Diane, and Joe. They were asked to create a 60 seconds radio jingle advertising Dano Milk, and they were also asked to judge each other's performance. For their performances, Mercy's team fell short as they forgot their lyrics. So other contestants were not very generous with your scores. They gave them really low scores, and Mercy did not take this so well, because when it was her own turn to judge, she also gave the housemates really low scores. She even gave Omashola's team 0. She didn't even care. She was frowning. She was pissed off because she felt like she was close to Omashola, and you should have at least considered giving her a fair score. With all the drama aside, Team Dano Choco, which is the team of Shay, Esther, and Venita, won for themselves 250k each and a year's supply of Dano Milk. The Saturday evening night party, DJ Humility came true while the housemates were styled by SGTC Clothing. The outfits were very lovely, and my favorite piece was Venita's outfits. The party was extremely boring to me, but we had a few standout housemates who were always a delight to watch. People like Mercy, Mike, Elo, and Kathy. For the Sunday eviction show, Leo Cash was invited to throw the crowd, and without so much ado, Ebuka evicted Joe and Enki. More and more people are leaving, guys, but the question is your faith still in the game, and does your faith have what it takes to win this season of Big Brother Naija? Well, let us know in the comment section of this post. Until next time, I am Samantha Mahmood. Please like, share, and subscribe to Plug TV Live, and follow us on all social media platforms at Plug TV Live. Goodbye. Bye.